This is Oldecam.
And this is not a spring chicken. Today we're going to be talking about how the economic stimulus plan could affect you.
Could affect you. I mean, I love that word, could.
Could.
You know, there's a difference between could and would.
Well, doesn't a lot of it have to do with time? Even that's why it's like, it's you're looking at your watch, 24 hours.
It's got to do with the fact that it is, days after the stimulus package has been signed, and nobody still really knows what's in the thing.
Well, you know what surprised me is usually when they do it, it's 48 hours.
It's supposed to have 48 hours between the time it is passed in the House and Senate for both sides to go over it. And this time, it said it was too important not to pass because it was more important to do something. Not to do something. I can tell you that doing nothing is always doing something. They have said that if nothing would have been done, the economy would have been fixed sooner on its own than it will be this way, because what they've done is pass a lot of entitlement programs. That everyone does know is in the bill of entitlement.
Well, you know, there's one hot market when it comes to jobs. Where do you expect that market to be? Government jobs.
But they said millions of workers can expect $13, depending upon how they fill that out, you know, on the things. They said it actually is supposed to be $13 a person, but it could be as little as $8 a household.
Oh.
It's $400 tax credit.
And it probably has to be.
Couples get up to $800. Up to
$800.
Which they said the basic one would get about $300.
Well, and part of it probably also has to do with your income.
The more you pay, the less you get. And they also have the marriage tax problem. If you're married, you get less money than a single person does.
So sometimes it's not a benefit to get married.
Yeah. Basically, next year you get $7.
Ooh.
That's right.
Ooh.
Basically,
wait a minute. It's got to affect us in better ways. There's got to be some good ways that it'll affect us.
Nobody found anything. It's not enough money to buy anything. It's not going to buy enough gas to get you back and forth to work, and it won't help your food budget any, so therefore...
But it will cost you nearly $4,000.
$3,700-some dollars per family is going to cost that $4,800.
Okay, we're going to try and find something good in this stimulus plan that can affect
you. Okay, here the middle-income and wealthy taxpayers will be spared from paying the alderman minimum tax. Now, the alderman minimum tax doesn't help the wealthy taxpayers. It never can. It's because some idiot put into law a thing that hit 20 million people. They were trying to screw the wealthy out of money, and instead lumped 20 million middle-income taxpayers in.
Isn't that always what happens?
Yeah, but that's like 78 million. 10% of the budget goes to that alone.
Well, wait a minute. So they're spared from the alternative.
Basically, Congress has fixed it each year for the last 20 years. Instead of just simply eliminating it, they fix it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. First time home buyers who purchase their homes before December 1st. Was that last year? 2009.
That's just December.
Okay. Would be eligible for an $8,000 tax credit if you will buy new cars for the end of the year. Get right off the sales tax.
Which they said is nothing, because the tax credit is going to be put on, for the house. So you buy an $800,000 home and it costs you $80,000 in taxes, meaning you only have to pay $71,000. It doesn't do anything for you. If you buy a car before the end of this year, you can write off the sales tax, which actually, depending upon where you add, is nothing or a lot. But then the area, and that's the federal tax, the local tax people are still going to stick it on you.
Oh.
You're still going to pay the sales tax, because they have no effect on the local.
Oh.
This is just the federal sales tax.
Oh, okay.
And then I love this one.
Homeowners who had energy-efficient windows, furnaces, and air conditioners can get a tax credit to cover 30% of the cost, up to a total of $1,500.
You got any idea what it costs to put any of this in your home?
A lot more than $1,500.
Add a zero to that $1,500, got just a start.
And that $1,500 is up to 30% of the cost, so that's starting at like $4,500.
Yeah.
Right.
But it costs three times that amount for the basic system anyway. So it's another law. Basically, it's too little to help the individual. They finished their people aren't investing in them because they can't get anything out. But the savings will occur over a decade, maybe.
Oh, ouch, ouch, ouch. So college students or their parents are eligible for tax credits of up to $2,500 to help pay tuition and related expenses in 2009 and 2010.
Yeah, which isn't going to help you in any college, I know.
$2,500, I mean, that helps you, what, if you go to City College?
Yeah, I think that pays for books.
Yeah. So, I mean, I guess it helps.
You might get to eat lunch.
But, you know, those are just tax credits.
Anybody know what a college
tax? Do you know how much it costs to come?
I mean, you're talking, it can cost you $100 for one textbook, and you can have five of those things, or six, or seven.
Well, at least they do have...
And then there's lab fees.
But at least they do have some things in here for education.
Yeah, but it's there, it was there anyway. They just refund it. A lot of this stuff, what you got to look at, is just refunding things.
Well, then why are they calling it a stimulus plan?
Because they weren't going to get funded under another way.
Oh.
They were going to lose their funding. So instead of cutting their funding out, they put it, they wrapped all this stuff together. What do we got?
I think they should have called it something different.
But those receiving unemployment benefits won't have to pay any federal income taxes on the first $2,400 they receive, which amounts to nothing.
Oh.
It's like that $13 a week again.
Okay. Okay, there's got to be some good stuff here. Health insurance. Many workers will lose their health insurance if they lose their job. They'll find it cheaper to keep that covered while they look for work. Right now, most people do the COBRA program, but it's expensive, often over $1,000 a month, because they pay them to share premiums, okay?
Yeah, but here's the part. The package will pick up 65 cents of total cost of the premium for the first 9 months. You're out of a job. You don't have any money. You can't pay for insurance.
You know, that's always been one of the problems with COBRA, is once you lose your job, you can get health benefits by paying the COBRA insurance, but you don't have the money to pay for it. And it's only for so long, and it's usually quite, and it's not about the same, it's usually quite a bit more expensive than it was for somebody.
Yeah, but there's a good one. And if you lose your job and you didn't have COBRA, you will have 2 months after the time you lost your job to apply for COBRA. Of course, you don't have any money to apply with.
I know, it's like...
But they also, they offer another 10% of the money goes to helping states administer Medicaid. It doesn't say to fund Medicaid. It says to administer. That's the bureaucracy part.
Oh, okay, so you want more money.
Yeah.
Okay.
The infrastructure, this is a good one. Infrastructure is the best one.
Highways, repaved for the first time in decades. Actually, there are some that could use it. Century-old water lines dug up and replaced with new pipes, aging bridges. I love this, of course. Aging bridges stressed under the weight of today's SUVs.
They're not talking about teamster-driven trucks. They're talking about public-driven SUVs that do not weigh a hell of a lot more than a truck.
Yeah. But the $90 billion is a mere down payment on what's needed to repair and improve the backlog. I love that part. It's a mere down payment.
Okay. So, first of all, this is for shovel-ready projects.
Now, tell them what shovel-ready is.
Shovel means that the designs are there. It doesn't mean it's been, the designs are there. They have approved it to go to the next stage. The next stage has to do with the court system.
Oh, and environmentalists. Part of it is, you may think we don't like environmentalists.
No, but well, okay, there is a...
They are good.
I say new structures should all be built green. There's no reason for it not to be. But if you're going in and repairing something that's already there, it's possible.
I know.
They've talked to one person after another that's involved with infrastructure rebuilding in this country. They said, first of all, the money, 30% of the money is going to go to illegal aliens. And the rest of the money goes to the regular workforce. But the problem is it's an 18-month to 5-year process to actually put a shovel in the ground to do it. We have projects in California that we have been waiting years on to get permission to build.
Well, actually, I can tell you, I love the projects that are started and they stop and they never finish them.
Because they get stopped by the environmentalists.